judges. En het mooie van die oproepkinderen is, ze zijn van BZ Belderop en Van Seijderveld. Zij krijgen gewoon de best seats op de house. Ofwel, zij gaan achter de baan zitten. Twee van die meiden komen lekker hier zitten. Meiden komen lekker hier zitten. En de twee andere meiden mogen aan de andere kant. We kunnen nu die wedstrijd optimaal volgen. Zij komen lekker hier. Kijk eens hier, zo. Schutteltje erbij. Ga lekker zitten. Zo, dan kun je de wedstrijd goed volgen, lekker zitten achterover. Nu super werk gedaan, zo. Moet je haar mooi laten. Heel goed. En dan de meiden van daar ook zitten. Wat een voorrecht hebben jullie. Echt de best seat op de house te gaan zitten. Geef ze een dame van de plaats. De meiden uit Down Under, Setyana, Mapasa en Gronya, Somerville. En dan hun tegenstanders. En als u nog in de spelen hebt gevolgd, heeft u hun in actie gezien. Ze wonnen één van de drie partijen in de groep in het vrouwendubbelspel. Het zijn inmiddels de nummers 17 van de wereld en hebben hierin al in de drie partijen gespeeld die ze redelijk makkelijk afgingen. Wat gaat dat worden tegen de dames uit Australië voor deze twee dames uit Bulgarije? Oftewel, de zusjes. Geef ze nog één keer een dame applaus. Gabriela en Stefani, Stoeva!
Ready to play.
Dames en heren, voor de hoogste duimpje nog aan het begin. Een vriendelijk verzoek. Als u zo dadelijk foto's maakt, deel het absoluut op social media. Maar ga niet flitsen of het lampje aanzetten. Ladies and gentlemen, no flash for cooking, please. During the play.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Setyana Mapasa, Gronya Somerville, Australia. And on my left, Gabriela Stoeva, Stefani Stoeva, Bulgaria. Gabriela Stoeva to serve to Gronya Somerville, love all, play. Fault. Service over, one love.
And you're very welcome back. It's one love to Mapasa and Somerville in yellow for Australia in this the women's doubles final, the YONEX Dutch Open 2016. As I said, the Australians are now closest to the
service
camera.
Service over,
Gronya Somerville on screen.
One all.
And in pink, representing Bulgaria. favourites for the tournament after the withdrawal of Evia Muschkins and Selena Peek of the Netherlands. And defending champions, of course, Gabriela and Stefani Stoeva.
Two, one.
Interesting head-to-head information from these two pairs of Stoevas. The 3-0 head-to-head advantage over the Australians, met three times in 2015. And on all three occasions,
service over
is coming through.
Two, all.
But an interesting statistic and worth thinking about is that two of those three matches were in three games. And certainly this Australian pair have improved a lot since that last meeting at the tail end of 2015
three,
in Turkey.
Two.
Now, while the Stoevas have a little bit of an up and down year as they apply their trade at the top level of the Super Series, certainly had two quarterfinals at Super
Service
Series
over,
level.
Three, all.
The latest coming at the Korean Open only a couple of weeks ago. Certainly a confidence boost for the ladies in pink. And they come back here to the Dutch Open as defending champions. And a title that they will certainly
four, three.
Want to win. After what was really an up and down year.
Service over.
Making that big step up the Super
four,
Series from being so
all.
Dominant around the Badminton Europe circuit. But the 2 years previous. And everything culminating, of course, in their appearance at the Olympic Games in Rio. Now with a distant memory, Rio. And the Australians
service
were
over.
Certainly heading towards Rio.
Five,
until the unfortunate
four.
Circumstances where they found out that they actually did not qualify. Certainly, Setyana Mapasa did not qualify due to her involvement, I think it was for Indonesia in the World Junior Championships a couple of years previous. And that put end to their attempt at Olympic qualification. So all to play for. 5-4, the story of his lead.
Certainly four.
When Setyana Mapasa is in the rear court, she can certainly match either of the Stoevas for power. Very physical player, Mapasa. One of these few players that you will see actually jump smashing. One of the few female players, that is.
Seven, four. Eight, four. Service over, 5-8.
What about their route to the final? Of course, the Australians come through the top half draw as third seeds, and they destroyed Anseli and Cho of Malaysia in their semi-final yesterday, 21-9, 21-12. Before that, in the previous round, took down one of Badminton Europe's top circuit pairs in Julie Finn Ibsen and Ricky Sorby Hansen of Denmark, and again, easy 17-8 two-game victory.
7-8.
Unlike the two pairs in the mixed doubles beforehand. the Australians have come through to this final without dropping a set. Excellent performance from the ladies in yellow. Another bottom half of the draw. The Stoeva is seeded two, of course, for this tournament.
9-7.
But after the withdrawal of the local home favourites, Efi Mushkins and Selena Peak. Selena suffering from a foot injury and unable to take part. The Bulgarians certainly elevated to favourites for this tournament.
Service over. 8-9.
Just like their Australian opponents today, the Bulgarians have come through without dropping a set. But it's been a little bit tighter in some games. Yesterday's semi-final, they were one game point down in the second game against the Malaysians. Managed to bring it through 22-20 in two games. Destroyed Emily Lefel and Antran. We just have to be fair and have to say that. 21-3, 21-14, where the Bulgarians barely got out of second gear. And before that, an interesting game against Karin Nystedt and Emma Wengberg of Sweden. Again, comfortable winning 21-13, 21-14. So not a set drop between the two pairs en route to this final.
Service over, 10-8. Service over, 9-10. Service over, 11-9 interval.
So it's the interval lead for the Bulgarians, 11-9. But I think the Australians will be quite happy with their start in this women's doubles final. You know, so often we've seen it before, certainly around Europe and on the Badminton Europe circuit, where the Bulgarians come out hard, come out heavy, race into an almost unassailable lead and mentally destroy their opponents. Australians are very much in touch after 7 to 8 minutes here in this final.
20 seconds, 20 seconds.
Cici and Gabby, two players who I know very well for many years, talking, interviewing, commentating, and being around them from juniors all the way up through the senior ranks. My first time ever, really, talk to the Australians. Very happy to have them in here in Europe. I know playing in the Danish
11-9
recently, and
play.
Had an interesting chat with Gronya yesterday about her name, about the spelling of her name, and about the undoubted Irish roots in that name, me being Irish. We spell it slightly different in Ireland. Oh, and there's the athleticism of both the Australians coming into play. And there's a photograph. Bastien, the photographer, is just behind the TV cameras that are off court. They'll be processing that one fairly quick.
So John, is your meal okay?
Dive to retrieve the shuttle. Sure what time it is in Australia, but I'm certainly sure there are some Australian badminton fans watching. If you are, you're very welcome to our coverage here of the YONEX Dutch Open, the women's doubles final. What is it, just approaching 2:15 here in Almere. Almere just about, I think, 40 kilometers southeast of Amsterdam. Some running repairs for Setyana Mapasa. A little bit of blood extracted in that dive across court. Of course, these courts, while great for badminton, are not very, very good for sliding on. And badminton mats and human skin. I've had a long and arduous relationship over the years. And what makes it even more difficult in a situation like this is that the players are warm and they're sweating, and it's very difficult to apply any sticking tape or bandage. So some running repairs for Setyana.
9 play.
She's back ready to play. 12-9 in favor of the Bulgarians. Good attack from Somerville. Very athletic Gronya. Shuttle. Did his best for the Australians, but just
13,
falling back their side of the
net. 9.
A lot of energy expended in that rally from Gronya Somerville. Sure, if you can see it, maybe on the replay.
Service over.
You see a lot of strapping
10,
on the right ankle.
13.
Of Stefani Stoeva, an injury she picked up about a year ago, maybe a little bit more than a year ago, but played through it through the Olympic qualification, and certainly has prevented her from playing singles. We must remember that she was a European champion in women's singles from 2013 in Ankara in Turkey. Accomplished singles player, and every time I talk to her in an interview, or I always ask her when is she going to come back and play singles, and there's always a little smile and a giggle. I think her heart is set on this women's doubles pairing, and focusing on her doubles in the short term, medium term future.
Service over, 14-10.
Communication between the Aussies.
15-10.
Sometimes the case when you have a left and a right hander on the same side of the net. Excellent net from Gabby. Dare I say it, the Australians just starting to look a little bit forlorn in this game.
False.
Better than Gronya Somerville.
Service over, 11-16.
Again, just blood continuing to come from that knee of Setyana Mapasa.
Fault.
Nothing left really from this, Stefani
Stoeva. 16.
Soft drop and then a poor lift and easy for Gronya Somerville to put away. Hanging in there, the Australians. Variety from Setyana. Oh, and then Gabby just finding that space. Great vision. from the elder.
Service over, 17
of the Stoeva sisters. There it is, right into the deep forehand corner. And this, the Bulgarian's favorite setup in attack. Gabby at the net. Stefani, a powerful right arm from the rear court. Cross-court smash in that final rally, in that last rally, just a little bit flat from Setyana Mapasa. Easy for Gabby to put flat back across.
Service over, 13-18. Service over, 19-13.
Yeah, you certainly in the replay see the look of dejection on the face of Setyana. That should have been a routine smash winner down the line. Fresh air shot, going for the interception.
Service over, 14-19.
Yeah, nice bit of luck. Shuttle bouncing off the top of the net court.
15,
landing over for the winner,
19.
Somerville. She'll take it. Clash of rackets.
Fault
again.
Service over, 20, game point, 15.
It's game point, 5 game points for the Stoevas. Ooh, rushed serve.
Service over.
And Gabby.
16-20.
Excellent rally. Best rally of the match so far. Very well controlled by the Australians. And good variation from Mapasa.
17.
Nice drops
mid
rally. And then that net. Front court winner was never coming back. It's going so hard on the ground, it'll probably end up in Australia. And they're fighting. They're still in this. Oh, hesitation. Hesitation from Gronya Somerville. Forced to come around on the backhand side. In the end, easy enough for the Stoevas.
First game 21-17. Won by Gabriela Stoeva, Stefani Stoeva, 21-17.
19 minutes. And now with the first game secured, certainly an uphill battle for the Australians. Certainly passages in that first game. They stuck to their game plan. Came out on top in some of the longer rallies for sure. Stoeva is the defending champions, who are in pole position here. The women's doubles final, Dutch Open 2016.
20 seconds. Second game, love all, play. Service over, one, love.
Just as they did in the opening game, the Australians get on the scoreboard first. 22 minutes gone in the match.
Two, love.
From the Australians. Good block from Somerville. Excellent play from Australia, and they've come out with a fresh intent in this second game.
3-love. For love. Five, love.
Five quick points from the pass on Somerville, and the Stoeva is just looking a little bit rocked. Forced error.
Service over
from Gronya.
1-5.
Gives the Stoeva sisters their first point in the second game. Service over, 6-2. Thank you. A little bit of brain freeze from Stefani Stoeva.
7-2.
Playing the net in way too high, too much air. Gronya Somerville pouncing forward for the kill. Very dangerous ploy off the serve, giving the attack directly away to the Stoevas with their power. Nice cross net from Gabby. Oh, excellent block from Somerville.
Service over, 3-8. Service over, 9-3. Service over, 4-9. Service over, 10-5. Come on. 11-5 interval.
It's the interval lead for the Australians, 11-5. And really, at 5 points in a row at the very beginning of this second game, setting the Australians up just nicely. And you sense the Stoevas are just feeling a little bit of pressure. Just watching them now, you can't see it, but I can see them in deep discussion. And just looking a little bit worried as they come back out on court. Australians again.
20 seconds.
With our coach.
20 seconds.
Gronya, no doubt, he's telling them to stick to the game plan. It's been working in this second game. Keep the pressure on.
Play.
Excellent for Somerville. And then a third shot in the rally where she intercepted on her forehand side. Excellent anticipation from the Aussie.
Service over, 6-12.
this beautiful ability to play excellent disguise in her shots from the rear court. And it's an excellent rally again from the Australians.
Service over. Service over, 7-13. Service over, 14-8. Service over, 9-15.
Certainly not Gronya Somerville's best serve of this tournament. Easily attacked, Gabriela. Oh, and two quick points for the Stoevas.
10,
keeps them in touch in the
15.
Second game.
Service over, 16-10.
Just not firing in all cylinders. And they've been put under a lot of pressure, of course, in this very dynamic Australian pair. Again, good defensive block from Somerville. Cross court from Mapasa. Yeah, she's certainly a flair. Player, Setyana Mapasa.
17.
Double action cross court midway through the rally. Just catching the Stoeva's a little bit flat footed. Serve out wide from Setyana. Oh, good net. Both girls. Brave.
Service over.
Stefani
11-17.
Take my pass it on at the net in that rally. The Stoevas are going to have to do, you know, they can't just rely on their all-out power in this match. They're going to have to put some variety in the attack.
12-17.
We didn't see it in the replay, but there was a little cross-court drop from Gabby that really swung the momentum in that rally. All the hard work, Setyana Mapasa. Good variation.
13,
a couple of drops,
17.
And following it up with the smash. And then the final one. Outside the tram line. And still, the Stoevas keep in touch in the second game.
Service
Australians are so strong in defense. Actually, sitting
14,
back when they make
17.
Those lifts and are quite comfortable when the power comes from the Stoevas. And then we have all the talent in the world and turn that defense into attack. Mix it up in the attack. The story of this, a little drop.
15, Stefani, 17.
And brought in the power. Again, the old reliable smash down the middle when you're playing the combination of a right-handed and a left-handed player. So many times pays dividend, even at the highest level. And from nowhere,
16,
6 points
17.
In a row. Stoyers are back within one. Again, that strong defense.
Service over 18. 16.
So many players certainly around Europe unable to deal with the power from the Stoevas.
19-16.
Gabby and Stefani, quite adept from the rear court, physically well prepared. The story of the sisters, certainly in this game, the Australians quite
service over
in defense.
17-19.
Serve from Gronya Somerville. Oh, what a time for your string to go. In control in the rally. Game point, the Australians 27.
Service over 20, game point 17. Game.
Unforced error. And Gabriela Stoeva throws her eyes to the heavens with that mistake. The net result is
second game won by Setyana Mapasa, Gronya Somerville, 21-17.
Excellent
one
set
game
from the
all.
Australians. 40 minutes gone and really soaking up the attack and soaking up the pressure from the Stoevas. And then having the shot and having the shots and having excellent racket control, change that defense into attack, really bearing fruit for the Australians. One set all, just as in the mixed doubles before. This match also going to the deciding set. The first time this week either pair have dropped a set, of course. And now we'll go down to a winner-take-all decider in this women's doubles final. here in Almere, the YONEX Dutch Open Finals.
Her knee is bleeding again. Twenty seconds. Final game, love all, play. One, love.
So the Australians continuing from where they left off in that second game.
Service over.
Almost perfect.
One all.
Intriguing match. We have one set all. And it's not very often we see Gabriela and Stefani Stoeva
service
under
over
pressure.
2-1.
Certainly when they were on the European circuit 2015, 2014, virtually unbeatable. The Australians in this final really asking questions of the Stoeva sisters.
3-1.
We had the situation in the second game where the Aussies ran into a 5-love lead. And here they are, 5-1 in the second. Oh, and I don't think Gronya expected.
Service over, 2-5.
That net shot to come back. The Australians who are on their toes, they are the ones that look the more likely in this third game.
Ball.
Great coverage again from Somerville.
Service big over.
Smile on her face.
6-2.
about the interception.
Service over, 3-6.
Interestingly here at the YONEX Dutch Open Finals, helicopter transport offered to all the players to come from the hotel to the arena here. Nice little touch from the organizers. Not all the players availed of the little 5-minute trip.
Service over, 7-3.
The normal four-wheel transport, but certainly a nice touch from the organizers, offering that little bit of style for all the finalists here at the Dutch Open.
8-3.
Stoeva is just looking out of ideas. Of course, you know, when you're the favorites, you're the one that everyone wants to beat.
Ball.
But they certainly haven't been playing their most fluid best this week.
9-3.
And the Australians can sense. They can sense the victory. They're playing.
Service full is over, 4-9.
The higher tempo, they're playing with a lot more variety, it has to be said. Shot in the book being played from the rear court by the Australians during that rally.
5-9.
Soft drops from Mapasa and a punch clear in the middle of the rally and the full-on smash. And again, we've seen it. We
service
see
over, 10-5. Service over, 6-10. Seven, ten.
That's better from the Stoevas, taking the Australians on at the net. Athletic figure will pass up with a bit of an error around her head.
8-10.
Cover so much ground.
Service over, 11-8 interval.
Goes the interval
change
lead again from the Australians, just as they did in the second game. Change of ends, of course, in this third and deciding set. But certainly sitting here courtside watching this match, you feel of the momentum certainly with the Australians in yellow. Every rally just seems to be a labored rally from the story of the sisters. Interesting to see what they can come up with during this interval. Gabriela doing much of the talking to her younger sister, Stefani.
20 seconds, 20 seconds.
Traveling these days, of course, without a coach. Won the European Games title, ooh, a year and 3 months ago in Baku, which transformed transformed their funding potential back home in Bulgaria.
11-8.
Straight after their Baku success, top funding from the government. Which has allowed them to go on to greater things, of course, applying their trade on the Super Series circuit.
Eight.
In 2016 has certainly been a year without a victory for the Stoevas. Dominated the European circuit in 2015. Won four straight tournaments, I remember. Welsh, Irish, Italian, and Turkey at the tail end of 2015. November and December time. Of course, international challenge events, those circuit tournaments. Last big one was really here last year, the Dutch Open Grand Prix. But had their quarterfinal in Korea only a few weeks ago. Got to a quarterfinal, three quarterfinals in a row. The French Bitburger Scottish Open Grand Prix, November 2015.
Okay,
but they would love a win. They're used
service
to winning.
Over.
They have been used to winning.
9-12.
Australians had that victory this year at the Canadian Open early in the summer.
Service over, 13-9.
In the Brazil International, which was also international challenge rated, and runners-up in Italy in 2015. On that occasion, of course, when the Stoevas won that tournament. Again, it's an execution variety from the rear court of Setyana Mapasa, which really does most of the damage for the Australian pair.
Service over, 10-13. Service over, 14-10.
Return of serve from the Stoevas, really setting up
service
the
over, easy, 11-14.
That short lift from Mapasa, who was really struggling deep in her rear backhand corner. It's getting to a point now where it's almost do or die for the Stoevas. Extremely athletic individual, Setyana Mapasa.
Service over, 15-11.
Three smashes and then could come in and still get off the ground for the jump smash.
Seventeen, eleven. Service over, 12-17. Service over, 18-12.
Two poor returns of serves from the Stoevas, and then very, very bad error on the flick serve. A little bit of a
service over,
comedic interlude.
13-18.
Judge called it out, but indicated in and shouted out sorry. Bit of a character, the same man. Difficult job sitting on the service line where the errors are really few and far between to try and stay concentrated during a match.
Service over. 19-13.
The Stoevas, really the lifeblood has gone out of them in this match. Looking a little bit resigned. We have the Australians winning two, winning their second Grand Prix of the year. They've really come to the Netherlands this week and set this tournament alight. Their effervescent style of play.
Setyana? Here.
The Australians unhappy with the line call.
Setyana, come here. Let the line review the call, okay? Service over, 14-19.
From the Stoeva's perspective, it's all in now. Gabriela needs to be rock steady on her serve. Oh, just out. Nothing going right.
Service
for the
over.
Stoeva sisters.
20. Match point. 15.
And after exactly 1 hour, it's the Australians who get the match point.
Service over, 16-20.
There it is. Second time of asking to take it. And it got to be said, they have deserved it. They were the pair with the most variety. They were the pair with the most determination. And they've come out on top, and certainly after losing that first game, tactically very aware in the second and third to come out on top and win their second title of the year. Gronya Somerville and Setyana Mapasa. Disappointment, of course, for the Stoevas. Defending champions here.
Match won by Setyana Mapasa.
Not be happy with their performance.
17-21, 21-17. 21-16.
Setyana Mapasa and Gronya Somerville from Australia take this title. Stay tuned for the prize giving ceremony. If possible, we'll try and get a quick interview with the Australians via our Facebook channel, Badminton Europe. Straight after the prize giving, next match on court then will be the men's singles. Asia Jara Mavilia, top seed against Su Wei Wang, second seeded in Chinese Taipei.
En dan, dames en heren, staan de dames er weer helemaal gereed voor. Ze komen natuurlijk uit de Almere buiten. Geef ze een draagde applaus.